Hey everyone, Jamie Phillips here, going over another game breakdown. This one is LA versus Columbus. One thing I want to add too is I do a ton of these along with my own original content, well, training sessions, drills, all that stuff on my Patreon. It's $5 until January 2nd, and then the price is going to go up to $10. So if you're interested, you like more of this, and you want to help support me and be able to, you know, well, support me, do what I love to do, and keep pumping out content like this. Every subscriber helps, so I appreciate it. So let's get into this. And I also haven't watched this game. It's from a while back. It was in my to-do list, and I just got around to it. And I also like to watch these games without knowing the score, because I like to just do it. Like to kind of watch it live, essentially. So I have like my first initial thoughts, and I want to see what actually happens. So obviously issue comes from the early drop. Tough, maybe that situation, although he's not super cocked back and ready to shoot, so not, I guess, I mean, perfect world, hold your feet. Everything, it's a lot easier said than done, although I also would not have been as aggressive from here, just in this situation, because it quick ends up getting caught with, who's that, Dubinsky in front? Yeah, just patience. I mean, like, you gotta be able to read whether that guy's looking past shot, especially if that stick isn't behind the body. It's typically not going to shoot, although like really good shooters like Matthews and stuff can hide that and still release quickly from in front of their body. Tip, that's about it. Just a tip. Thought he played that pretty well. Looking around the screen, fighting for it. Good. I guess Sportsnet added in their own little circle. That wasn't me. Yeah. Really tight tip. Not much you can do on that. Thought his positioning was okay. He was on angle. Everything was in line for that him to eat that in the logo. That quick change of direction is all it takes. Who's in net? Merzļikins or Corbusel? I like this angle. I wish I could get this angle in like training sessions. Pretty good patience, I would say. Yeah, good patience till that puck gets dropped. One thing to note, and this is a good lesson, so typically in plays like this, or like a 2-on-1 where the guy's driving wide, which in this case, it's not 2-on-1, but he's driving wide, a player is receiving this puck on their backhand is going to catch and go back and continue with the puck. A player on their forehand, it's a lot easier for them to, they're either going to have to go forehand backwards, which is a tough play, or they're going to tip and quick shot. So knowing what hand that guy's receiving the puck on, anytime a guy's picking that on the backhand, you should be aware that 80-90% of the time, I also just made that stat up, but the majority of the time, they're going to cut back. It's a lot easier to get that puck up on their forehand than it is on the backhand. Where yes, Kopitar could have tipped that, you know, that's an NHL play, but you can still react even if he tips. That go in. All right, not a great turnover. That's why you never trust your D. Oh, there's a lot going on. Okay, so from the RVH, whiffs on it, bounces off Columbus's guy. Does that go in? Oh, yeah, it does. Again, just unfortunate luck. Very scrambly, though, Merzļikins. Through the arm. Former teammate Jack Roslovic. Okay. 2-on-1. Aggressive. Very aggressive. Definitely too aggressive. If that player, again, you got, if you see that player lining up for the 1T, very rarely will a player look off a one-timer guy. So I would be slightly deeper just to give myself a little bit more of a chance to chase the middle and get in position. The other thing I don't like here is how late Quick's chest is. So when I teach, I'm more of a snap the chest, leave the chest. Your chest is the biggest part of your body. It's connected to your hip. Your hips are connected to your knees. Your knees are connected to your ankle. And also, your head's not going to move. Your head rarely moves independent of your chest. Your head moves rarely moves independent of your chest. Where your chest... No, did I say that wrong? Your head moves. Your chest very rarely moves independent of your head, but your head often moves independent of your chest. So by snapping the chest, it's much easier to get yourself square to the puck, which then should hopefully put you in a better position to make that save. So because Quick's so far behind, because of his depth and he's late with his chest, he has to slide. And as soon as we slide, sort of turns into a crapshoot because now this is a desperation save. We're now out of control. And by slide, I mean slide in the splits. So I should say that. So come across in the splits. So it just goes through them. So there's a lot of things. Do you think Roslovic's going to look off line? Probably not. So it's knowing who's on the ice, what hand they are, what the situation is. So you might have to adjust your depth, especially if they make that play really high. Whereas if that D starts to take away the pass, then you know that, okay, this prize is probably going to shoot. You can adjust your positioning accordingly. Oh, lordy. Okay. So, talking about not scoring up your chest. Merzlikin's chest is up ice. His head's facing the puck. That's what I said. And I mean that your head can move independent of your chest, but your chest rarely moves independent of your head. So in this situation, what I'd rather see is him come across with that chest, getting in position here, which look and see how unsquare his glove leg is, where if that glove leg is a little bit square, he might have a bit more of a sense of where he is in his net, because now he's off his angle, meaning there's a lot more of this side square. He ends up squaring up his chest, but now he's off angle, and he just completely blows past his net. So that one is that one's on the goalie, for sure. You can see here, just the way he moves, he like does that shimmy shuffle. Like, I'm not a fan of that. Why is that red mark there? Like, I don't like that little like shimmy shuffle. I would rather hit a cut with that foot, square the chest up, and shuffle, rather than a double foot cut, but, you know, it is what it is. It is what it is, and I don't even think he gets square. So, he is not square. So he's both not square and not on angle. Chest is not facing the puck. Hips are not facing the puck. Toes are not facing the puck. The only thing that's facing the puck is his head. Now he ends up getting off angle. Now he's not off angles, so there's nothing running through. Oh, that's a horrible line. The middle of the net. No bueno. For me, that breaks down with just his approach into the shot.
He's a phenomenal skater. So, I would be really suggesting goalies that are really good skaters, shouldn't be much of an issue to get that adjustment. And again, a lot of that stems from depth. Jeez, Jack's having a big game here. Lots of goals too. You just start picking games with less goals so you can watch some good saves. Two on one, yes. It's hard. It's a hard read. As soon as you pick it up here, he's probably not shooting. Also, I don't think the D should continue back, but whatever, I'm not D coach. It's just quite aggressive for that pass option. Once in this play, you have to know that player's continuing to creep down. So you might want to be a little deeper, toes top, or no, definitely not heels in the white, just to give yourself a fighting chance to make that save. Maybe you don't make it, but at least you give yourself a chance. Is that Dubois? He doesn't even... No, Dubois is not in Columbus anymore. Whoever that is, he doesn't even handle the puck anymore. Or handle the puck in a way to shoot it. It's an immediate pass. What the heck is going on here? All right, this one, this is just... Quick is a very good goalie, obviously. Two-time Stanley Cup, three-time? Two-time Stanley Cup champion. But he also likes to do too much. Comes across in this slide when the guy's not shooting in his... his paddle down. Now he's out of control. He's lost his balance. He's too wide. He then resets. He's off his angle. It's not square. When, you'll see goalies that... other goalies in the NHL try to play with more poise and technique, and that's a good time. That's a good... Who's drawing lines? That's not me drawing lines. I don't really know what I'm trying to say. What I'm saying is play with a little more control if possible. The only thing is the reason he was so out of control in this save is because he comes right out to the white here. If Quick's here, knowing one-timer, he's going to make the save. He's a freaking good goalie. He doesn't need to be this aggressive. And when you're here and that pass comes across, you have much less of a distance to move. You don't have to come across in the splits, pile down. Now you don't lose yourself in the scramble. Now you can get in a good position to make that save. Don't love that body language by Merzļikins. Do not love that body language because players feed off of you as a goalie. Poor Chuck. Through a screen, absolutely. Poor track. Poor tracks lead to bad rebounds. Bad rebounds often lead to goals. I feel like the games I'm doing, there's just so many goals. I mean, goals against has been the highest ever in the NHL in the last 10 years. But still. Sorry, wrong way. It's hard to tell. Would a paddle down been acceptable? Yeah, we'll use paddle down. But that rebound goes forward. Gets scrambled. Turns it over. Ugh. All right, a little bit of OT. So again, like, Quicks is so aggressive that he just always comes across in the splits. It's just so, like, yes, unfortunate rebound. But from this position, he doesn't need to come across in the splits. So the likelihood of that rebound coming off is a lot lower. Now, obviously, it goes off the Columbus guy and in, which top bounce. But it just, to me, it feels like he always comes across in the splits when he's so fast and explosive. He doesn't need to. He just doesn't need to. Are they going to review this? Are they going to call it off? Oh, here we go. Oh, that's no way that's a goal. Oh, but then their own guy puts it in. Oh, yeah, the own guy puts it in. All right. Well, hope you enjoyed watching. Like I said, Patreon's $5.